Hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome to the session of PIB 24/7. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session as usually I will bring to you five important questions from the PIB news. To chaliye guys start karte hain aaj ka session with question number 1, which is about India's first Kisan Rail. So the question is, with respect to India's first Kisan Rail, identify the correct statements. So we have to identify the correct statements with respect to the India's first Kisan Rail. So guys, recently Minister of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare and Minister of Railway Mr. Piyush Goyal has flagged off India's first Kisan Rail from Devlali, which is a place in Nashik of Maharashtra, to Danapur, which is in Patna of Bihar. Alright, so India's first Kisan Rail has been flagged off by the two ministers from Devlali to Danapur, and this rail has been launched for building a seamless cold supply chain for the perishable items. जैसे कुछ आइटम्स गाइस ऐसे होते हैं जो कि बहुत जल्दी खराब हो जाते हैं, जैसे कुछ फ्रूट्स ऐसे होते हैं, कुछ वेजिटेबल्स ऐसे होते हैं, सो उनकी सप्लाई चेन को डेवलप करने के लिए इस स्टेप को लिया गया है बाय द गवर्नमेंट, एंड आल्सो टू डबल फार्मर्स इनकम बाय द ईयर 2020. नाउ ये जो स्टेप है इंडियाज फर्स्ट किसान रेल, हाउ विल इट इंक्रीज द इनकम ऑफ फार्मर्स? सो इट इज वेरी इजी टू आंसर गाइस, बिकॉज since there will be a good supply chain for the perishable items, so if the supply chain will be enhanced, then also the farmers produce will get access to the market very easily, and also jo perishable item jo farmers ke pehle kharab ho jaya karte the, ab unko properly market tak kharab hone se pehle pahuncha diya jayega. So these are the aim and these are the objectives of this step. And these are some other points that are worth to be noted. Like for example, this will be the first ever multi-commodity trains. इससे पहले single commodity trains भी चली हैं. Like India's first fruit train के बारे में आपने सुना होगा. Few months back, it was flagged off from the Tadipatri railway station of Andhra Pradesh. Right? India's first fruit train was flagged off from the Tadipatri railway station. It is in Andhra Pradesh. Also, aggressive marketing is being done with local farmers, APMC, and individuals. And the very important point is that guys, the freight of this train will be charged as per the parcel tariff of the normal train. जो normal train के parcel tariff होते हैं उतना ही इसका भी freight होगा, कोई महंगा नहीं होगा. Alright, so this is very important point and you should remember this point. Okay, now let's move on to the question. Question was, we have to identify the correct statement. So it has been introduced from Devlali to Danapur. Yes, this is absolutely correct. This train will have special tariffs which are more than the normal train. No, it will be same as the parcel tariff of the normal train. And statement number 3 is, it aims at building cold supply chain for perishables. Yes, this is also correct. So hamare paas 1 or 3 statements hai jo ki bilkul correct hai. So therefore the correct answer will be guys what, option B, only 1 and 3. And now let's move on to question number 2 and 3, which is about a program which is known as Tsunami Ready, that was launched by UNESCO IOC. IOC stands for Intergovernmental Oceanographic Commission. Okay, so now let us first discuss about this. So there was a virtual event on tsunami by UNESCO IOC, and in this event Tsunami Ready program has been launched, which is a community performance based program initiated by IOC to promote tsunami preparedness and to ensure that there will be a robust mechanism of tsunami warning system, right? And this tsunami preparedness will be done through active collaboration of public community leaders, national and local level leaders, and emergency management agencies, right? So सभी को साथ में लेके, मतलब public को, community leaders को, national and local level leaders को, emergency management agency को, इन सभी को साथ में लेके tsunami preparedness के इस program को launch किया गया है, and of course इन सभी की मदद से हम tsunami prepared हो सकते हैं, okay? And guys, if you talk about the objectives of this program, so objectives are very clear: to improve coastal communities' preparedness for tsunami emergencies, to minimize the loss of life and property, and to ensure a structural and systematic approach in building community preparedness. Of course guys, ki agar hamare paas tsunami preparedness hoga acche se, to jo hamari coastal areas ki community hai unko hum prepare kar payenge taki wo tsunami ka samna kar sake properly. और अगर वो सुनामी का सामना प्रॉपरली कर पाएंगे तो जो हर साल हमारी बहुत सारा लॉस ऑफ लाइफ एंड प्रॉपर्टी होता है उसको मिनिमाइज किया जा सकेगा. एंड ऑफ कोर्स देयर विल बी अ स्ट्रक्चरल एंड सिस्टमैटिक अप्रोच इन बिल्डिंग कम्युनिटी प्रिपेयर्डनेस. ओके एंड गाइस, दीज आर सम अदर पॉइंट्स दैट आर वर्थ टू बी नोटेड. लाइक फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इंडिया इज द फर्स्ट कंट्री टू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस प्रोग्राम सुनामी रेडी इन द इंडियन ओशन रीजन, एंड इन इंडिया ओडिशा इज द फर्स्ट स्टेट. The Odisha State Disaster Management Authority has implemented this program in two villages, which are Venkat Raipur in the Ganjam district and Nolia Sahi in the Jagat, सिंगपुर डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ उड़ीसा. ओके एंड इंडिया हैज ऑल्सो एन अर्ली वार्निंग सेंटर विच इज नोन एज इंडियन सुनामी अर्ली वार्निंग सेंटर विच वर्क्स अंडर एनकॉइस एंड एनकॉइस इन इंडिया इज द नोडल एजेंसी टू प्रोवाइड सुनामी एडवाइजरीज इन इंडिया. And guys, remember one thing which is very important, that INCOIS also provides tsunami advisory to the 25 countries in the Indian Ocean region as a service provider, and this responsibility has been given to India by IOC UNESCO. Okay, and ITEWC, which is Indian Tsunami Early Warning Center, also conducts IO wave tsunami mock exercises biannually in the Indian Ocean region. And guys, what will be the benefit of this program? So guys, we all know that every year in the Indian Ocean region, tsunami aata hi aata, and due to that, we lose a lot of life and property every year. Okay, so agar hamare citizens tsunami prepared rahenge, then they will be able to tackle the situation, tackle the tsunami. And also, I think, in my opinion, there must be some guidelines or there must be some manuals on what to do after the citizens receive the warning system. Okay, agar ek warning system kisi citizen ko mili hai, to uske baad kya karega? Because there should be some uniformity in the steps taken by the citizens after they have received the warning system. Because agar sab log alag alag tarike se apne aap ko bachayenge, then it can also create a chaos among the citizens, right? So wo kafi zyada ajeeb sa ho jayega. So there should be some guidelines and manuals jiski madad se hum citizens ko ye bata sake that what they have to do after they have received a guidelines, after they have received a warning of tsunami. Okay, and now let's talk about IOC, which was established in the year 1960, and it is the only organization within the UN system for the marine sciences. And its objectives are very clear from its name. Like its objective is to maintain ocean ecosystems healthy and sustained, to provide effective early warning systems and preparedness for tsunami and other ocean related hazards, to increase resiliency to climate change and variability and enhance safety, and also to enhance knowledge of emerging ocean science issue. Okay, so these are some basic objectives. You can easily identify the objectives of these type of organizations. Isko aapko specially yaad karne ki koi zarurat nahi hai, and there are no exceptions ki agar koi alag sa iska objective hota then wo hame yaad karna padta, but there are not such exemptions. Okay, and now let's talk about INCOIS. So it was established in 1999 under the Ministry of Earth Sciences as an autonomous organization, and it provides the best possible ocean information and advisories to all the stakeholders like society, industry, government agencies and the scientific community, right? And in the year 2007, this early warning system, which is Indian Tsunami Early Warning System at Indian Tsunami Early Warning Center, was established in INCOIS by the Ministry of Earth Sciences, right? So guys, I hope aapko ye pura ka pura news clear hai and there are no doubts. So now let's move on to question number 2 and 3. So which country is the first in Indian Ocean region to implement Tsunami Ready, which is a performance based incentive program to promote tsunami preparedness? So in the Indian Ocean region, India is the first such country to implement this, and in India, Odisha is the first state. Odisha Chief Minister is Naveen Patnaik, party is Biju Janata Dal. Okay, and now question number 3. With respect to the Tsunami Ready, identify the correct statements. It has been initiated by IOC of UNESCO. Yes, UNESCO guys is headquartered in Paris, and let me ask you a question. Can you tell me 4 other important organizations which are located in Paris? Write down in the comments. Write down the name of 4 important organizations which are also located in Paris. And number 2 statement is that its objective is to minimize the loss of life and property, jo ki har saal tsunami ki wajah se hota hai. Yes, this is also correct. And Karnataka is the first state in India to implement Tsunami Ready. No, this is incorrect. The first state in India is Odisha, right? So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option A, only 1 and 2. Now let's move on to the next news. Yes. So question number 4 is, which center has been established by Ministry of Jal Shakti to maintain and update the recently launched new version of the India Water Resources Information System? So guys, recently Ministry of Jal Shakti has launched this new version of India Water Resources Information System. And for the maintenance and updation of this system, MOJS, Ministry of Jal Shakti, has established National Water Informatics Center. And he is the Minister of Jal Shakti. His name is Gajendra Singh Shekhawat. His Lok Sabha constituency is Jodhpur. Okay. And guys, if you talk about the key points, so iske kuch key points hai. This system is accessible through the web portal www.indiawris.gov.in. And this portal will provide information related to rainfall, water levels and discharge of rivers, water bodies, groundwater levels, reservoir storages, evapotranspiration and soil moisture. And guys, evapotranspiration का मतलब क्या होता है? So this is nothing but the sum of evaporation and transpiration. Okay, evaporation and transpiration को combine करके हमने बोला है यहाँ पे evapotranspiration. There is nothing new and I hope आपको evaporation और transpiration का मतलब पता है. And what are the benefits of launching this system? So there are a lot of benefits and it can provide benefits to a large number of people like farmers and farmer welfare association can use the information provided this portal to plan their crops and cropping patterns. Other individuals can also use the data to know the availability of water in their local area. Planners and administrators can utilize this data for their respective states and they will be able to reduce the impact of flood and drought due to the information, and researchers can also utilize the data for water related studies and modeling purposes. Okay, so these are some benefits and these can be asked guys in the exam. Isme se ye bahut general se benefits hai aur isko exam mein pucha ja sakta hai. So now let's move on to the question. Question is, which center has been established by MoJS to maintain and update the recently launched new version of India water resources information system? So this center guys is National Water Informatics Center. Option B is the correct answer. And now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which institute under the Ministry of Defense has won the first prize in Smart India Hackathon 2020? So recently guys, Smart India Hackathon 2020 conclude hua. So usme humne batana hai ki kaun se institute ne Ministry of Defense ke first prize jeeta hai. So Defense Institute of Advanced Technology, which is in Pune, and it is an autonomous organization under DRDO. DRDO guys, it is chaired by G. Satish Reddy. Okay, G. Satish Reddy is the chairperson of DRDO, and Defense Institute of Advanced Technology has won the first prize in Smart India Hackathon 2020. And this program, this prize has been given to this institute for problem solving statement MS-331 in the category of software posed by the Madhya Pradesh government. And you must not remember this state, this point कि कौन से problem statement में उनको ये prize मिला, ये आपको याद रखने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. ये मैंने आपको इसलिए provide करा दिया ताकि आपको knowledge में रहे कि इनको ये prize किस लिए मिला था. Alright, and for solving this problem they have provided a solution, Drishti, for the face expression and gesture recognition using artificial intelligence. And the Smart India Hackathon 2020 was the national level competition for software edition organized by Ministry of Education and AICTE, and it took place at Noida Institute of Engineering and Technology. And if you talk about this institute, so this was established in the year 1952 under the Ministry of Defense and it is located in Pune. So this is all you should know about this news. Itna kafi hai, isse zyada bahar koi question nahi aa sakta. So now let's move on to the question. So the institute guys is Defense Institute of Advanced Technology. So option A will be the correct answer. Okay guys, so that's it for the session today. I hope you like it. For more updates, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. And for more sessions like this, do buy our paid courses for RBI, Grade B, SEBI, NABARD and UGC. Thank you so much for watching. Aapko ye session kaisa laga? Comment karke zarur bataye. Thank you so much. Goodbye. Take care and God bless.